Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about the lecture series for accuracy, precision, and greatest possible error. This is actually a Math 101 topic that some of you will be doing in Math 90 or 94. So let's go ahead and look at what's on the screen here. Remember, you can always double click on the screen to get rid of the picture of me and to just look at the screen and what I'm working on so you can see it a little clearer. When we talk about accuracy of a measurement, we're talking about the number of significant digits it contains. These indicate the number of units we have counted and are able to rely on. There's some rules for significant digits, so let's look at that. All non-zero digits are significant. A digit is a number, and non-zero just means it's some number that's not zero. So for this one, 12,348, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 significant digits. Some zeros are significant and some aren't. So the zeros are the ones that are usually tricky for people. All zeros between non-zero digits are significant. So do you see how this zero is between the two ones? That makes it significant. These two are not between significant digits, so they're not significant. So 1, 2, 3, 4 significant digits. A zero in a whole number measurement with a special tag is significant. Maybe this person wanted to be significant to the hundreds, but the measurement came out with a zero, so they put a tag over it so you know to include that as significant. So that means we have 1, 1, 2, 3 significant digits there. All zeros to the right of a decimal point and a significant digit are significant. If they're to the right of the decimal point and right of the significant digit. So in this case, we have a decimal point here. These two are to the right of the decimal point, but not of a significant digit. So only these two zeros would count because they're to the right of the decimal point and they're to the right of that 5 there. So we have 3 significant digits here. Okay, a good thing to do right now would be to shut the video off or pause it. Try all of these and then come back and see how you do. I'm going to go through these significant digits. These are not in between significant digits, so they're not significant, so we just have 2 for that one. The next one, this is like the one up here. We have these zeros in front, but they're not significant because they're not between, or they aren't to the right of the significant digit there. So we just have 2 in that one. This zero is significant because it's sandwiched in between other significant digits, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this one this is a little tricky, but this 5 and this 6 are significant, right? So everything in between that is significant. And this one is following the decimal and it's after the 6. So all of those digits are significant, so we have 6. Here, all of these are significant because the 2 zeros in between the 1 and the 4 are sandwiched in between there, which makes them significant. Here, we have all of these also are significant because these 2, because they're in between 2 significant digits, and these 2 because they're following a decimal and a significant digit. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I don't know why I wrote this over 2. I should have just written that bar over 1, 0. Because if I have this one, I'm saying to you, I've tagged that as significant, then this 0 is significant because it's in between 2 significant digits. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4. Anything after that tag is not significant if it's all zeros. And in this one, I have 3 significant digits because this 0 is between 2 numbers. These are at the end, so it's 3. All right, so hopefully you tried those on your own and then you came back and you had them all right. The other topic on this video is precision. Significant digits are important and they matter because the precision of our instrument is measured. The precision of our measurements is determined by the position of the last significant digit. Again, try a few of these on your own to make sure you get them right. We're going to say how many significant digits there are, and we're going to say what the precision is. Well, there's 2 significant digits followed by a couple of zeros. So I'm going to say 2. I think this video is a little blurry. I can't tell sometimes whoops, from my screen what's actually happening. Let's see if that improves it a little bit, sorry. And now the precision, well, the precision is to the hundreds because the last significant digit, then we're talking about precision, we're talking about where's that last significant digit. The last significant digit is in the hundreds place. So the precision is to the hundreds. And if I wanted to write that as a decimal, I would say 0.01 to the 100s. That would be hundredths. Sorry, this is just hundredths. That's not true. We're talking about to the 100 yards. Sorry, I made a mistake. That happens. Don't freak out. Sometimes you make mistakes and you just got to move on. The second one we have, how many significant digits? Well, they're all significant. This one because it's in between two numbers, and this one because it follows a decimal and a significant. So we have four significant digits, and the precision is to this is our last significant digit, last one being the one furthest most to the right. So we have this one, and that's tenths, hundredths, thousandths, so it's to the thousandths place. And so this one has the TH on the end, which makes it thousandths, like that, to the 1,000th of a meter. You can also say 1,000th that way, right? Because three decimal places is the same as three zeros under the fraction like that. Okay, what's the significant digits for the next one? Well, here we are, and so this is not significant because it's after that, but everything before that is significant. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 significant digits. That is the tens place. So that we're talking about to the nearest 10 centimeters. Down below I have these millimeters, mm, centimeters, cm, meters is m, kilometers, km, in case you've forgotten what those mean. What about the precision to D? Well, D has, well, first of all, the significant digits, there's two. Because these zeros are all just in front of anything that's significant, so they don't count. We have these two that are significant. This is our significant, our last significant digit. And so if I think about this, tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths, hundred thousandths. I can't even fit this on here. I'm going to do this, hundred, I guess I could have planned a little better on that, hundred thousandths, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 places. Or I can say it as hundred thousandths with five zeros under there, right? The next one has three significant digits and it's to the ones place. So it's to the nearest 1 foot. The next one is here, which is to the which is three significant digits, and it's to the thousands, to the nearest 1,000 miles. Well, why would they even do that? Well, if you're talking about the distance to Mars or something, within 1,000 miles would be okay, right? So precision, when we're talking about a really long distance, might be okay. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because they're all non-zero, and we're at the tenths place, which is 0.1 or 1 over 10 tenths, 1/10 of an inch is the most precise we can get with that measurement. And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All of these are significant. These zeros are all sandwiched in between significant things. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then that's to the hundredths, what I tried to do on the first one. And that is 0.01 or 1/100. All right, so those are significant digits. We use significant digits when we're talking about accuracy and precision. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.